Some passengers on board that Southwest Airlines flight with an engine failure are getting a $5,000 check and a $1,000 travel voucher from the airline in an effort to restore their confidence. It comes as we're learning more about the heroes who stepped into action on that plane when a woman was nearly sucked out of the window, including firefighter Andrew Needham, who helped pull the victim, Jennifer Reardon, back into the cabin and tried to save her life.
God created a servant heart in me, and I felt the calling to get up and do something, stand up and act. I'm no different than any other firefighter in this country. For some reason, whatever reason that is, it was me that day.
Joining us now, another hero on board that flight, retired nurse Peggy Phillips, who helped to administer CPR on the victim. Peggy, we appreciate you taking some time for us. First of all, how are you doing today?
You know, it's been sort of a whirlwind. All of this is really very new to me. I'm really a pretty low-key person as far as getting myself out in front of people and the media. So this has been brand new and a little terrifying. So yeah. I'm a little tired, and I worked yesterday and I'll work today too. So, but you know, hanging in there, I'm doing okay. I'm fine.
When all of this happened on the flight, you immediately, you hear the call, we need somebody who knows CPR. You immediately run back, you start to help. Do you remember those moments? Do you remember what was going through your mind?
You know, it was really, I'm trying to think how to put it. I was really almost relieved to hear them say, we need someone who knows CPR, because I thought, I can help, I know this, this is my skill set, I can do this, I'm a registered nurse, I can do this, I can help someone. And that was the last thought I had before I went back and started helping Andrew.
And was that a relief in some ways for you, because you had someone else to focus on? You could help in that moment and distract yourself as well from the reality of everything else that was happening?
It absolutely was. It helped me, because I'm sort of an action person anyway, and to just sit there and know that basically everything was out of my control. For a registered nurse, we're not used to that. Mm-hmm. We're used to sort of being in control, and when I could get up and actually do something I was trained to do and hopefully help someone, then it was a sense of relief for me. It really was.
You had said that you realized pretty quickly that Jennifer Reardon would need more than CPR, and yet you didn't give up.
No, you don't. That is part of the training that you get for CPR is you continue, and you want to give the person every chance that you possibly can, and you want to walk away from the whole incident and feel like you, no matter what the outcome was, you did your best. You tried your hardest to save a life.
We've seen pictures of Jennifer Reardon over the last couple of days. We know she's a mother of two, well loved by her community, by her family. Mm-hmm. Have you had any interaction with her family?
I have not. My thoughts and prayers are with them daily. There's probably not a moment in the day that goes by that I don't think about them. And I know how devastating this is to them, and I know how much they're suffering. But, you know, I just want them to know that she was never left alone. There was always someone with her, and we definitely tried our very best.
Mm-hmm. You know, rallying around her in those moments, and just to hear that your loved one was not alone can make such a difference too. We cannot ignore also the heroics of Tammy Jo Schultz, the pilot here, and the crew, who have been praised endlessly, as they should be. Did you have any interaction with either the pilot or the crew when that flight landed?
You know, several of the flight attendants came up and hugged me. They were directly involved in the whole situation that we were in at the time. The pilot was so gracious and so calm. She walked down and literally leaned over into each row of seats and asked, is everyone okay? She was very concerned about everyone. She showed incredible compassion and poise, and I was incredibly impressed by her.
A lot of people, I think, are saying the same thing, even a number of people who were not on that flight. We know, as we mentioned, Southwest is extending some money and travel vouchers, and there was some talk about how that could also be used for counseling. Is that something that you see yourself doing, sitting down, talking with someone about about what you did just go through a few days ago?
You know, I'm very blessed. I have a wonderful support system with all my fellow nurses. They have all reached out to me in various and sundry ways. And that has been, that's the way that I can cope with it and can deal with it, because they understand exactly what happened and how I was feeling at the moment, because that's how they would be feeling too. And that has been a blessing to me.
Peggy Phillips, appreciate you taking some time for us. I know it's been a whirlwind. Thank you.
It has been, but you're so very welcome.
There are some good people on that plane, and they made a huge difference.
Absolutely.
Thousands of students across the country planning a walkout today. They are demanding gun control reform, and they picked today for a reason. We have a live report from Parkland, Florida, where there's student-led movement.